वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ओपन स्फीयर एंड क्लोज स्फीयर देन आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम एग्जांपल्स ऑन ओपन स्फीयर एंड क्लोज स्फीयर सो फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ ओपन स्फीयर Definition. Let x comma d be a metric space. Let x belongs to x and r greater than 0. Remember here. R is real number, be a real number. The open sphere with center x and radius r denoted by srx is the subset of x given by we have here open sphere SRX is equal to it is the set of all those points of x whose distance from x is less than r that is it is the set of y belongs to x such that distance between x and y is less than r here now for understanding purpose we are drawing this Now suppose this is the set x. Now we have taken point x here. Okay? Then now this distance is r. Now if you consider all these points which lies inside inside this circular curve here so all these points is the open sphere SRX it means that if you take now this point now distance between now this point and center x is less than r so therefore now y is in this set now if you take now this point okay say z now here now distance between x and z is equal to we have r here okay now I have taken now this point here So the distance between x and z is equal to we have r. So therefore, z does not belong to this open sphere. Obviously, if you take now, suppose this point w here. Now distance between x and w is greater than r here. So therefore, okay. Now since distance between x and w is greater than r here, so therefore w is also not in the open sphere SRX so remember now we consider those points here whose distance is strictly less than r here okay it means that if SRX is the open sphere then we consider those y whose distance from x is strictly less than r here remember now we are drawing this circle here but in general case open sphere need not be but you should remember that okay open sphere in general is not always circular Okay, so for understanding purpose we are drawing this. You should note that an open sphere is always non-empty set because it contains its center at least. Now, example of open sphere. So first example is this. Now, in the usual metric space, RU, the open sphere, SRX0 is the open interval, x0 minus r to x0 plus r, where x0 is a real number and r is also a real number which is greater than 0. Now remember here, now we know that here we have x is equal to ru. Ru, it means the x is equal to, we have r and it is usual metric here. That is, we have distance between x and y is equal to absolute value of x minus y for all x and y belongs to, now x, that is we have r here. Now SRX0 is equal to, now by definition of open sphere we write here x belongs to r here, such that distance between x and x0 is less than r. So we write here x belongs to r, such that here now d of x comma x0, that is distance between x and x0, is less than r. Now we know that distance function is this, so we write here absolute value of x minus x0 is less than r. So we write here the set where x belongs to r, now minus r is less than x minus x0 is less than r. Now adding x0 in this inequality, we write here x belongs to r, such that we have here x0 minus r is less than x is less than x0 plus r. So this is nothing but the set of points which lies between x0 minus r to x0 plus r. That is, here we have here this open interval x0 minus r to x0 plus r. Now for understanding purpose, if you consider this real line r, okay, now x0 is any point here. Now from this point at a distance r, okay, that is distance between now this point and this point is r, so we have here x0 plus r. Now again we can take distance r on left hand side, that is we take a point x0 minus r at a distance r on left side, so we get x0 minus r here. Now if you exclude now x0 minus r and x0 plus r, then all the points, now here I am bolding this, I am shading this. Now these points is the open sphere SRX0. Okay, actually these points is nothing but the set open interval x0 minus r to x0 plus r. So remember this. Now here in this case the open sphere SRX0 is x0 minus r to x0 plus r. So in the usual metric space RU, the open sphere is always the open interval x0 minus r to x0 plus r. Okay, now the next example.
Remember that every open sphere in the usual metric space is an open interval, but the converse is not true. Because if you consider this, now this set, open interval minus infinity to plus infinity. Now this is an open interval, but this is not open sphere, because here we cannot find R such that we have SRX node is equal to open interval minus infinity to plus infinity. That's why this set is open interval, but this set is not open set. So you should remember this. Now the second example is this. So second example is, now in the usual metric space CU, in the usual matrix space CU, that is here set is now set of all non-zero complex numbers. Okay, now in the usual matrix space CU, that is we have X is equal to C, that is the set is set of all complex numbers. The open sphere SRZ0, where Z0 is a complex number, is the circular disk absolute value of or modulus of Z minus Z naught less than R, where Z naught belongs to C and R is greater than 0. Now here SRZ naught is now this set. So we have here Z belongs to C such that distance between Z and Z naught is less than R. Now here the metric is the usual metric, that is we have absolute value metric here. So therefore we write here absolute value of Z minus Z naught is less than R. But we know that if Z is equal to X plus IY belongs to C, and Z naught, which is X naught plus IY naught, again belongs to C, then absolute value or modulus of Z minus Z naught is nothing but, actually here absolute value or modulus of X minus X naught plus I into Y minus Y naught, which is equal to, we have square root of X minus X naught square plus Y minus Y naught bracket square. So therefore yes, we write here SRZ naught or open sphere SRZ naught is equal to, it is the set of all those complex numbers belongs to C such that the distance between Z and Z naught is less than R. So we write here such that square root of X minus X naught bracket square plus Y minus Y naught bracket square is less than R. So on squaring we write here X minus X naught bracket square. Now we want to remove this square root sign, so we take square on both the sides. So we write here X minus X naught bracket square plus Y minus Y naught bracket square is less than R square. Actually this is nothing but the interior part of the circle. Okay, now consider this complex plane. Now this is real axis, say X, this is Y, imaginary axis Y. Now consider this point Z naught. Z naught is X naught plus I Y naught, which is also represented by X naught comma Y naught. Okay, then draw the circle of radius R here. Okay, now this distance is R here, that is the radius of the circle is R. Now we consider all the points which lies inside this circle. So set of all these points is the open sphere S R Z not here.
So R is the distance here. Now Z not is the center of this sphere. So if you take now this complex number, now distance between now these two, that is Z not and Z is less than R. Now if you take now this point Z1 here, now distance between Z0 and Z1 is less than R. So therefore now Z1 lies in this open sphere. So remember that here the open sphere is the interior of the circle of radius R here. Now the next example is open spheres in discrete matrix space. So third one is this, in the discrete matrix space, discrete matrix space XD. Now remember, in discrete matrix space we have distance between x and y is equal to 0 or 1. Okay, distance between x and y is 0 when we have x is equal to y. Okay, distance between x and y is equal to 0 if we have x is equal to y, and this is if x is not equal to y. Okay, then the open sphere now in this matrix space. Now we take any point, so let x naught belongs to x be any point, be any point in the discrete matrix space. Now we know that distance between x and y here is either 0 or 1, so we consider this in two parts. So if 0 is less than r is less than or equal to 1, okay, then we are going to see what is the open sphere here. So we consider this, the open sphere S R x naught, that is the center is x naught. So x belongs to x such that distance between x and x naught is less than r. Now here value of r lies between now 0 and 1. It means that we can take r is equal to 1 also, or r is equal to, we can take here 0.1, 0.2, or any real value which lies between 0 and 1 excluding 0. So if we take r is equal to 1, then distance between x and x naught is less than 1. But we know that in that case we have distance between x and y is equal to 0, because we know that for any two distinct points we have distance between x and y is equal to 1. So if we consider r is equal to 1, then we get here distance between x and x naught is less than 1. That is, we get here, okay, it is a set here. So x belongs to x such that distance between x and x naught is equal to 0. But we know that when we have this x, distance between x and x naught is equal to 0, it means that we have x is equal to y. So therefore we get here x belongs to x such that we have x is equal to x naught. That is, here we get singleton set x naught. So remember, when value of r is greater than 0 but less than or equal to 1, then in that case open sphere S R x naught is the singleton set x naught. Now if value of r is greater than 1, that is you can take 1.1 or 1.01, 1.02 or any value greater than 1, then S R x naught, that is the open sphere S R x naught, is the set of elements of x such that distance between x and x naught is less than r. Now here we are taking value of r greater than 1, so we get here, okay, distance between x and x naught is equal to 1, because here value of r is greater than 1, and we know that distance between x and y is equal to we have 1 when x is not equal to y. Okay, it means that now in this case, now this open sphere is the whole set now x. So remember, when r is greater than 1, then in that case the open sphere SRX0 is the set x here. Okay, then the open sphere SRX0 is the whole set x here. Now next example is this. In the metric space R square or R2 comma D. Now here D is the metric. D is the metric. It means that now here D's function is D of x comma y is equal to we have square root of x1 minus y1 bracket square plus x2 minus y2 bracket square. For now here x is equal to we have now ordered pair x1 comma x2, and y is equal to we have ordered pair y1 comma y2 belongs to R2. The unit open sphere centered at origin is given by now open sphere S1 whose center is at origin, that is 0 comma 0, is the set of points x1 comma x2 belongs to R2 such that x1 square plus x2 square is less than 1. Now this is the metric function defined on R2. So by definition, yes, we write here S1 0 comma 0, or that is ordered pair 0 comma 0 is equal to, now we write here the set of all ordered pairs belongs to R2 such that distance between now x1 x2 comma the origin, because here center is the origin here, so we know that coordinates of the center are 0 comma 0 here, so we have 0 comma 0 is less than 1 because here radius is 1. So we write this, so x1 ordered pair x1 comma x2 belongs to R2. Now we use this metric function, we write here square root of now x1 minus 0 bracket square plus x2 minus 0 bracket square is less than 1, so which is equal to we have now square root of x1 minus 0 bracket square plus x2 minus 0 bracket square less than 1 gives us square root of x1 square plus x2 square. Now this is less than 1. Now we want to remove this square root sign. For that, yes, we take square on both the sides here, that is we write here x1 square plus x2 square less than 1. So if you draw this, then you will find that now this is x1 axis, this is x2 axis in the R2 plane. Now this is the origin here. Now we want to draw here now this open sphere, so we consider this point. So here now this distance is 1 unit here, that is this point is 1 comma 0, then this is 0 comma 1, this point is minus 1 comma 0, and this point is now 0 comma minus 1. Now remember here, now this is the, actually this is the circle, so x1 square plus x2 square is equal to we have 1, but you should consider all the points which lies inside this circle. So remember, here the open sphere or the unit open sphere S100 is the set of points which lies inside this circle. Okay, so that is the interior of this circle is the set S100. So this is the open sphere. Okay, whose center is at origin and radius is equal to, we have 1. So this set is nothing but the this now shaded region here. Then next example is, now we are again drawing the unit open sphere on R2, but here we are using different distance function here, that is d star. So in the matrix space R2 with matrix d star. Now definition of d star is this: d star of x comma y is now maximum of absolute value of x1 minus y1 comma absolute value of x2 minus y2 for x is equal to ordered pair x1 comma x2 and y is equal to where ordered pair y1 comma y2 belongs to R2. Now here we want to draw the unit open sphere. The unit open sphere, the unit open sphere with center at origin, centered at origin and radius is 1 is given by S1. Now we know that here radius is 1. Now center is origin here, so we write 0, 0 or ordered pair 0, 0 is the set of points of R2, that is ordered pair x1 comma x2 belongs to R2, such that d star of x comma 0, actually x comma 0, it means that you can write here now ordered pair x1 comma x2, then here origin is now this point, so we write ordered pair 0 comma 0 is less than 1. So we write the set ordered pair x1 comma x2 belongs to R2, such that now maximum value of absolute value of x1 minus 0 comma x2 minus 0, this is less than 1. So we write the set ordered pair x1 comma x2 belongs to R2, such that yes, maximum value of absolute value of x1 here, because x1 minus 0 is x1 comma absolute value of x2, which is less than 1. Now we want to draw this unit open sphere. For that we consider this R2 plane. So this is x1 axis, this is x2 axis. Now the point of intersection of these two is the origin here. Now here the open unit open sphere whose center is at origin and radius is 1 is now this. So we consider this line now first, so which is x1 is equal to 1. So if you draw this, it means that now points on this line always have a first coordinate or x1 coordinate as 1, then this is now line x2 is equal to 1. Okay, then again draw a parallel line which is x1 is equal to minus 1, then this is now x2 is equal to minus 1. Now remember here, now we are considering now maximum value of
absolute value of x1 and x2, and that value must be less than 1. So it means that if you consider all the points which do not lie on this line or on this edges of this square, so if you consider those points which lies inside this square, then they satisfy now this condition, that is maximum value of absolute value of x1 and absolute value of x2 is less than 1. So it means that now in this case the open sphere or the unit open sphere centered at origin is this region. Now remember here, now length of this side is 2 unit, again the length of this topmost side is 2 unit, then this side is also 2 unit. So this is the unit open sphere with center at origin. Now remember, now this unit open sphere is not circular here, okay. Now this is the square here, okay, this is the square having now length of each side is equal to 2. So this is the open sphere with respect to metric D star. Then next example is again on R2, but metric is D star star. So in the metric space R2 with metric D star star, now here the metric D star star is, now D star star of x comma y is equal to absolute value of x1 minus y1 plus absolute value of x2 minus y2 for x is equal to we have ordered pair x1 comma x2 and y is equal to we have ordered pair y1 comma y2 belongs to R2. Now we want to draw the unit open sphere here, okay, whose center is at origin. The unit open sphere centered at origin is given by now we are using definition of open sphere here, so we write here S1, center is now origin, so we write ordered pair 0 comma 0 which is equal to now set of points in the R2 such that we have D star star of ordered pair x1 comma x2 comma 0 comma 0, this is less than 1. So we write here ordered pair x1 comma x2 belongs to R2 such that, now D star star is this function, so we have here absolute value of x1 minus 0 plus absolute value of x2 minus 0 is less than 1. So we get here the set of points in R2 such that absolute value of x1 plus absolute value of x2 is less than 1. Now we want to draw this open sphere. So to draw this open sphere, we again consider the plane R2 here, where now this is x1 axis, now this is the origin here, and this is vertical line is the x2 axis. Now we have here absolute value of x1 plus absolute value of x2 is less than 1, okay. Now to draw this unit open sphere, now only draw the line x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. So it means that here if you draw this, then suppose this point is now 1 comma 0, this point is 0 comma 1, now then the equation of the line is x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. Then similarly, now take this point on negative x1 axis, now join this by this segment, now again take now this point 0 comma minus 1, now join these points, okay, by the segment. So Now here, now this region, okay, this region is the set of points S1 0, 0, that is the open sphere with respect to metric D star star is now this set, okay, this shaded region is the unit open sphere. Now remember here, now we are taking this, but if you consider now points on this segment, then they do not lie, okay, then they do not lie in this open sphere, okay, or they are not members of this open sphere, because here actually we have absolute value of x1 plus absolute value of x2 is less than 1, and we are taking here x1 plus x2 is equal to 1 to draw this unit open sphere. So remember this. Now we are taking this x1 plus x2 is equal to 1 because, okay, for understanding purpose, now consider this absolute value of x1 plus absolute value of x2 is equal to 1. Okay, then when x1 is greater than 0 and x2 is also greater than 0, then we have x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. Okay, when x1 is negative, then we write here minus x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. Okay, then second case, that is when x1 is positive and x2 is negative, then we write here x1 minus x2 is equal to 1. Okay, when both x1 and x2 are negative, then minus x1 minus x2 is equal to 1. That is, you can write x1 plus x2 is equal to minus 1. Okay, that is this one. So now the last one is this. Then now x1 minus x2. So when x2 is 0, x1 is 1, and when x1 is 0, x2 is minus 1. So now this is, okay, this portion has equation x1 minus x2 is equal to 1, okay, and one more. Now for this side, you can write this equation minus x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. So today we have seen all these about now the open spheres. That is, we have drawn some open spheres by using some functions here. So thank you.